All right, welcome back to the channel. I'm going to talk about why you should avoid using Windows Home Edition. This goes for 10 and 11, especially 11 though. Now, before we get super in depth on the reasons that I would say to definitely avoid it, I want to give a shout out to Leo over at the PC Security channel. He made this video a few months ago talking about has Windows become spyware, and he was using Wireshark to test all the connections that are going in and out of Windows on a fresh Windows install and all of the spying and telemetry and all that kind of garbage going on. And there is just an unbelievable amount of shit that runs on Windows Home Edition. Pro has it not as bad as Home. Home is definitely the worst. Pro still has a lot of telemetry. You can go check this video out if you want to. I'll link it below. But I'm going to get into the specific reasons why Home sucks, especially when you compare it even to just like using Windows Pro, but especially, you know, if you're able to use like Windows Enterprise, it's way better. Now, this is a very clean, super fresh install of Windows 11 Home Edition. And the only thing that I have done here is install Portmaster. Now, Portmaster is a nice firewall. It's got sort of like Wireshark. It's got like network activity and you can do DNS filtering and all that kind of stuff. But this is completely clean. Now, when I booted into this, I opened up Portmaster right away. And within 1 minute, there was about 140 total connections, which is about what Leo at the PC Security Channel, when he tested, he had about the same results. 140 connections, there's a whole bunch of stuff that came up here. So there's telemetry coming in from OneDrive and all this other stuff. This is just the stuff that's still running right now. And you can see when you're scrolling through Portmaster, and for some reason it's not showing me the whole window here, so I can't scroll down and go to the next page. It's sometimes it's glitches. But you can see all of this garbage, and you can see that Portmaster blocks some of it, but let's check this out, for example. So this is one of their telemetry connections right here that Portmaster blocked, and this is using the default block list that comes with Portmaster through telemetry. So you can see it's trying to send your data over to an address in Singapore. Okay, then you've got incoming connections, you've got outgoing connections that are being allowed. So you've got all of this stuff from Microsoft Edge. A lot of telemetry goes out, it hooks through the svchost.exe. And it goes out. So just an absolute ton of spying. I mean, you could come here and you could install this, or you can install Wireshark and just run it on like Windows Home or Windows Pro and just see how much spying is taking place on your computer. Now, the other reason that Windows Home really sucks is you're missing out on Bitlocker. Now, a lot of people might think, well, Bitlocker's not really that big of a deal. I don't need encryption. If you're not running encryption, you really should be. There's really no reason not to. Now, it's been years since I used Windows Home, and by the way, let me just show you this before we go any further on BitLocker. Let me just show you this. I haven't used Windows Home in years, and this is why. Like, when I come in here, got all this garbage here. We got Spotify, WhatsApp, all this trash here, TikTok. Now, these are not actually installed on the computer yet. As soon as you click on this, it does install it through the Microsoft Store. This is basically just a placeholder where you can open these up. But the amount of privacy and security risk that you open yourself up to by having all of this junk, all this shit on your computer is just unbelievable. I mean, when I got loaded in here and I saw how much just absolute trash in Windows Home. I mean, it's ridiculous. Now, back to BitLocker. I had to look this up because I guess they've changed it in Windows 11 a little bit. You used to be able to turn on device encryption. I guess they've changed it for Windows 11 to like where now you have to, you're using an online account is mandatory. And if you don't use it, which you can bypass using an online account for Windows 11. You have to do the command prompt when you're installing Windows and you're booting in. But you don't even have the option of using device encryption. So Now, apparently what I've heard is this turns on automatically if you link it to a Microsoft account. I'm not gonna link a Microsoft account to this. I mean, that'd be stupid. But you don't even get that option. You also don't even have BitLocker. And for the people who, I'm sure most people are up to speed on why encryption is so important, but if you're not aware, let's say you lose your hard drive or it gets stolen or whatever, if someone gets access to it and they pull up, they can look, if you don't have your hard drive encrypted, they can pull everything off there. They could see every single file that you've got on there. They can open everything up. You absolutely need to be running encryption these days. And the problem is even if you link device security to, you know, let's say you create, you're on home and you do have device encryption on, which is not the same as BitLocker. You know, you still have to, it's still linked to the TPM and whatnot, but it still is not as good of an option as actually using BitLocker. And so, like I said, you don't even get that option in Windows 10 Home or Windows 11 Home. Now, the other thing, it's Windows 10 and 11, by the way. The other thing is you also don't get group policy. Now, I've seen some people talk about how, well, you can just run a command and it will install group policy and you can make all these changes to group policy, which the first part of it is true. You can run a couple of commands here, which I ran them for the system because I'm going to show you something. So you can install group policy, but the problem is it's not actually group policy. You can't really go and change things. And some people have said, well, you can make some changes. The problem is no one knows exactly what you can change that actually takes effect, because there are literally thousands of policies in Microsoft Group Policy. So here's an example. Now, when you install Group Policy on Windows Home, for all intents and purposes, this shit doesn't work. You can't actually do anything with any of this. For example here, this Windows Home and I went down to BitLocker drive encryption. BitLocker isn't even installed on here. And yet I've got all these options to configure BitLocker. And it's the same with everything else. Let's open up data collection. This is where you can shut off a lot of telemetry. Now, if you're running Windows Pro or Windows Enterprise, you can come in and shut a lot of garbage off. You still have to have some telemetry on Windows Pro. They won't let you completely shut it down. But you can disable quite a bit of stuff in Windows Pro, and if you're on Enterprise, you can basically shut down all of the telemetry on the system. Now, the type of people that are going to watch this video are probably the type of people that would want to know why they should upgrade to Windows Pro, and those are some of the bigger reasons. There's other stuff too. For example, you get Hyper-V on Windows Pro, but you don't get that on Home. Now, one of the reasons that a lot of people would use it is to create a virtual machine, which, I mean, that's great. I actually like using it. It's better than having to use something like VMware because it's already baked into Windows. The other thing is Hyper-V does enable some extra security features that keep you secure on Windows. And I'm obviously a cybersecurity person, so there's that aspect of it, and that's something I talk about a lot. And I'll go into that on a further video about what it is that Hyper-V does for Windows when it comes to security. Now, if you want to use, for those that, let's say you're running on a Windows Home license, if you're unaware, Microsoft gives Windows away for free. Now, I'm not gonna go into it in this video. Microsoft, you could Google like Microsoft support activation or something like that. I'm sure you could find some articles that are out there. This stuff was going, there are some articles running about it not too long ago, but basically you can get Windows for free and Microsoft doesn't care. There's even a certain tool or script that's on a Microsoft-owned website. I'll leave it at that. Microsoft apparently doesn't care. Even their support service uses it. So Pro is a lot nicer. You can shut down a lot of this trash on Windows Pro. You can go into group policy and disable a lot of the telemetry that's going on with your system. You can also use tools like Portmaster here to turn off a lot of stuff through lists. And for those of you that have never used Windows Enterprise, I mean, you're missing out. I mean, this is why I hear some people say that Windows Enterprise is what Windows, the regular version of Windows, should be. And I'm telling you, after using Windows Enterprise and then coming back to like Windows Home, even for like a test system, wow. I mean, this is just absolute garbage using this stuff. And then you have Windows LTSC. So for those who are watching this, just one more note that I'll end on. Windows 11 LTSC should be releasing soon for those of you that have used the long-term service channel releases. I believe Windows 11 LTSC should be coming out sometime in the near future. I'm looking forward to using that one and seeing how that is. Windows 10 LTSC, I believe, still has support for about another 2 years. Super nice. If you've never used it, there are obviously some issues to be aware of. If you're going to go use like Windows 10 LTSC, just something to be aware of. It is super, super bare bones. Like, you don't even have the Windows Store. You don't have the Xbox app. You don't have any of this stuff. Like, it is super bare bones. It's really what Windows should be. You know, if you're gonna pay to use a product like this, you shouldn't have to deal with this kind of garbage. But if you're gonna use LTSC, you know, you watch this video and you're looking at it like, oh, maybe that's something I wanna use. Just something to be aware of. There are some things that really aren't gonna work that well. Like for example, if you go try and play, let's say Halo, let's say you have it through the Steam store and you wanna go play Halo, and you try to run it on LTSC, you can't just go and run it. You're gonna have to jump through some hoops to get it working because you're not gonna have like the Xbox app. You don't have the Microsoft store, any of that. But I would implore you to at least, if you're running Windows Home, to at least upgrade to Windows Pro. If you're the type of person watching this, or watching any of the videos on my channel, you're probably trying to improve your tech skills, trying to learn more about cybersecurity. Windows Home is just an absolute dumpster fire. I would not use this garbage at all. Anyway, with that being said, that's gonna wrap the video up. If you like it, make sure you drop a comment, drop a like, all that good stuff. If you hate it, dislike, I don't give a shit. I'll see you in the next one.